So of course now he's not doing anything. That's where it should be, behind bars. That's a restaurant we had dinner in our first night here, Mr. B's Bistro. Really, really good. This is where we're going for dinner Saturday night. Okay, today is Friday. You can see we didn't take too many pictures yesterday. It was kind of overcast and really kind of lousy out. This is a place that we just had breakfast. It's called The Cavern. You can see it's an old slave's quarters. It's kind of neat. Food wasn't all that good, but setup was kind of neat. I mean, this is genuine slave quarters, because where else can you see a giant alligator with water coming out of the top of its head? Okay. This is on the grounds of the, I'm calling it Humus Plantation. I don't really know how you pronounce it. Looks kind of neat.
Okay, those are hexagonal garçonnières.
That's what I was going to call them.
Each side of the mansion. In the days when visitors had traveled long distances by riverboat or horseback, they usually had to remain overnight. These structures housed the visiting garçon.
That was never going to end.
We believe those are about 150 years old and were probably planted about the same time this mansion was built. If any of you saw the movie Hush, Hush, Sweet Charlotte, right about here was where she was standing when she threw the urns over on her cousin. Luckily for the actors, they were made out of paper mache. The statues out by the front fence represent the four seasons. The one to my father's left is spring, and then summer. On this side is autumn, and winter's hidden behind the moon. In case some of you are not familiar, these live oak trees do stay green all year round. In March, they lose their old leaves, but at the same time, new ones are coming along. There's only one moss in existence, to my knowledge, and it's fire.
Thank you. will immediately notice, of course, Mrs. Randolph's touch. In all the descriptions behind that lady, the first lady that lived in this home, she did love flowers. And on these gardens around the house, she would raise the first cut flowers. Even in the wintertime, we're told, had a greenhouse in front, with a white garden to raise the cut flowers, Mrs. Randolph. So that's the way she always decorated the home. They decided to do the same thing. And every Friday, these flowers are arranged right back there in our new florist shop. We have two ladies on our staff.
Sure what this thing is, a black squirrel, is what Diane said. What does she know? Yeah. This is behind that plantation. Now, what is that? Is that the Mississippi?
Yeah.
We're standing on a levee, looking out to the Mississippi. They built the levees to protect the homes. This guy's house used to be right up against the river, and they built this thing to keep it from flooding. And there's the house that we were just in. To a tour guide, the guy that took us to the cemetery, this is Anne Rice's house. This is the one interview with the vampire and all of that. She lives here. This is a small place.
This is Lafayette Cemetery, the one that figures into the vampire trilogies. And Anne Rice's home is just a couple blocks from here.
This was the one that they said you don't go in by yourself. This is right across the street from the Commander's Palace. Let me just swing around here so I'm going too fast. Down the street there is the Commander's Palace, where we had dinner for our anniversary. Doesn't look like much from the outside. The color, apparently, I forget what the guy on the tour said, that they used those colors to keep away evil spirits or something, I don't know. This whole place, these are all, this is like in the garden district, it's called. They're just all these gigantic homes that Some are open to the public, some aren't. This is Anne Rice's house again. Diane said she felt weird because, you know, like sneaking around looking at her house, but then she looked it up in her book and it's some historic place. So now she doesn't feel as bad. Neighborhood the same as like in Bensalem. Today is Saturday. This is our last day. We're going on a swamp tour, and this is a cemetery along the way. So this is an Indian spot over here. They always used to bury them in mounds. And here's the exclusive tour bus that we're on. It's just the two of us, plus the woman that was on the other thing, on the graveyard tour.
Thank you. a lot of people ask me how you determine the sex of an alligator. There's a slit on his belly, and you have to put your hand in there to feel if it's male or female. That's the only way you can find out. And when you do that, you always wear gloves. Always. You don't want to catch Gatorade. She was looking at me so serious. I started laughing.
Protection.
Now,
weird.
And Big Joe McKinney was there. He was standing at my shoulder. His eyes were bloodshot red. The church was right around him.
And then I go over here.
Yeah, once they get out of these drums, like there's a drum, then they get out. They go put them over there.
Then I sell them.
Okay.
Were these just caught?
I know these came from a farm. Well, these were wild, but they come from a freezer.
This is Fort Knox, aren't they?
That's
half of Fort Knox. What is it? They're rolled up? Is that
they're
what
rolled
it is?
Up and they're in salt. They're curing them, I guess. Ooh, it burns my eyes. What is the
It smells really good here. Feed anyone?
And they have to use tongs and things to put the food in. They can't.
Oh, he's still wild. Then
look at him, what a sweet boy.
Now, if they had brought him in and handled him from the beginning, then
no, even,
still wouldn't
even
work.
Then, yeah, they're really wild. This is
what a
they
sweet
have to have
face.
Go through a lot to get permission to cage these, only because they're a farm. Not anybody can keep a wild animal here in Louisiana. This is a swamp rabbit.
Looks nervous.
They're hot. They're hot in the sun. They should put some. I think.
This is a bobcat. In case we could
put some
hear.
Moss, drape some moss over there. So, because he's panning. He always pushes those feet.
Oh, he
does.
Oh,
yeah.
What? You don't want to go back here?
What is that thing?
Oh.
Did he get him? No, but he's just.
What is it?
A nutrient.
Oh, okay.
Oh, he's washing
himself. Yeah. The wall is a soft shield. Oh, look at that. I didn't even see that one. I'll just end it. This is Saturday night. We're going home tomorrow. This is the last of the tape. There you go. Okay, well, knowing Diane and I were trying to squeeze in as much as we can, we came back to this Metairie cemetery before going back to the airport. This is this particular spot is called the Millionaire Circle, and you'll see why. A little bit quieter than Bourbon Street. When we were with this guy from the voodoo museum, he knew who a lot of these people were. I don't remember the names, but they were all prominent, you know, people, obviously. Okay, we're headed to the airport. Enough vacation.